Today, we will discuss two topics, the structure of the Earth and deformation within the crust. We'll start with the Earth's structure. What are the major divisions in the Earth? There are three. The core is in the center of the Earth. It's about 3,400 kilometers thick. The inner part is solid and the outer part is liquid. That outer liquid part of the core is the source of the magnetic field. And we'll talk more about the magnetic field in one of our subsequent videos. The mantle is 2,800 kilometers thick and is in the middle part of the Earth. It is solid. The outer part of the Earth is the crust. It's thin. It ranges from around 5 kilometers in the oceans to approximately 70 kilometers underneath the continents. Remember that the continents are made of granite and the oceans are made of basalt. We'll now focus on the upper part of the mantle and the crust. The first is the lithosphere, which is composed of rigid plates. These are the rigid plates of plate tectonics, the plates that move across the globe. So if the plates are moving, what do you need for the plates to move? They have to slide on something, and it would be much easier if there was some lubrication. That lubrication is provided in the asthenosphere. It's plastic, and the plates slide on it. How do we know about the inner part of the Earth, the core, the mantle, the crust? Well, some of you may remember some movies like The Core. Perhaps you think we actually go down there. We do not. We cannot go down there. We have to use geophysical techniques or remote sensing techniques to evaluate the structure within the Earth. These include study of seismic waves, which we will discuss in one of our subsequent videos, as well as gravity studies. Now let's talk about deformation within the crust. Because of plate movements and other factors, stresses are exerted on rocks. What happens? Rocks can bend, which can produce folds, and then they can break, which produces faults and earthquakes. For example, got a simple pad of paper. If I compress it, I can produce bending up, which is an anticline. On the other hand, it can also produce synclines, bending down like that. If I continue to apply compression, for example, to this block diagram, here you have layers of the Earth. If I continue to compress the crust, I can produce a situation where this piece of rock can go up relative to the other piece of rock, and what do you produce? A fault and an earthquake. Okay? This kind of movement, okay, is called a reverse fault. This kind of movement is caused by tension, not compression, pulling apart. That's a normal fault. So compression causes reverse faults, tension causes normal faults. And then there's one other type of fault. That's a case where the plates or the rocks slip by each other like this. This is an airplane view, so imagine you're looking down on the land and you get sliding like this. An example of that would be the San Andreas Fault.